vision that must be fulfilled. So vision is biblical ambition. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. You are being very ambitious. But even in the absence of vision, God will work with your ambition. Because God has a vision for your life. He has a pattern. He has a purpose and a plan. And so therefore, his vision must swallow your ambition. Vision. So what is vision, Dr. Riches? Vision is a picture of the future before your eyes. God was telling Joshua, you are going to take your territory and all the days of your life. No man will stand before you. As I was Moses, I will be with you. So God was telling Joshua, he was telling Joshua a vision as to where he was going, as to what to be done. Hallelujah. Vision. Vision is a picture of the future before your very eyes that demands practical, spiritual, definite, deliberate action and secondary investment to get it done. I read that again. A picture of your very eyes of the future that demands practical steps. Noah built the ark. I mean, did the ark as a revelation, but it took practical steps to build the ark. Nehemiah built the walls. It took, there was spiritual there, but it had to be a revelation. He took practical steps to build the walls. So, this is not definitely spiritual. So, the thing, Lord, is your God, but it has to have a component that will be alignment for fulfillment. Vision becomes a reality. Vision. So it demands a practical step, definite, deliberate action. You know what you are doing to God, so you take action. Noah took action. He was definite, he was intentional to build a ark. Only God can most in the wilderness happy to December. Moses take an offering. So we will not have Moses. He can consider it, but you obey. It was a vision of God building something. I have discovered when God gave me a vision, out of that vision, we can plan, progress, and projects. And don't plan, progress, and projects and plan. They are God initiated and God will back up and begin to pass. For example, I went to the university on God's experience. When God got out of college, God sent me to college. Granted, all of my postgraduate said, God paid for it. That went down, but then God is up to something. How did I know? I look at it at the point about the God educated me in the case. So God paid it. The vision, he made preparation. Adequate preparation. When God called Moses, Moses had a vision to go into the nation. It was bigger than Moses. He had a first step to go to Egypt. He had a first step to bring them back. God, he fasted and prayed, but he ended up fasting and praying. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The God for sacrifices. You forgo some things that you want to do for yourself. You can't do it because the vision demands it. Indeed, vision is expensive. Ambition is cheap. Vision is expensive. It's ahead of my life. It will take everything that belongs to you. It will take everything that you think you have. And you put it in the vehicle. The vision must come to you. I don't want to go about to write the vision. Make it clean. Eh? Don't just talk it, write it. So other people can run. You need runners in the vision. You need support of the vision. You need prayer of the vision. And I'm talking to somebody here.
That's right.
Platform. We talk about vision in the platform. So vision defines your direction. It makes you set goals in life. It provokes purpose. You live a purpose-driven life because you know you have something to fulfill. Paul said, I am what I am by the grace of God. I can do all things God has called me to do. Hallelujah. Through Christ who empowered me. Through Christ who support me. But my God will supply everything I need to fulfill the vision. That is a vision, man. That is a vision. If you tell the vision to anybody, you see, he gets in God's vision. So the vision, without vision, we go anywhere. God will give you vision for your life. How for your life to move so you can make progress. God will get vision for you, for your family. He get vision for the ministry. God determine direction. When God calls you, he doesn't show you everything. He shows you one thing. If you follow, if you don't fall. When you play with vision, play with destiny. Every destiny tied to vision. Without vision, you will never understand your destiny. Joseph, Genesis 37, he had two dreams. And a dream led him to go into prison. You know, that takes the moment we came to ministry, you know, we felt that we knew God so much and we want to see God. And there was a time when we questioned, cause I'm doing it, my brother, there are about to find the levels of things. God will prune you. God will break you. You will suffer. God will put a band on you. God will misuse you. But if you don't use that for yourself, you can be useful to God.
Amen.
For that brokenness. You not broken, God can use you. So you take all the credits of the things God is doing. You think that you know. You can't. Alcohol, you can't. So the blackboard was people is vision. How far can you see this yet? Where is God taking you? Where are we going as a commission this year?
Forward.
Importance of vision. Vision determines where you are, where you are going by the grace and the power of God. Man of grace, you can fulfill vision. You need grace. And it's all over this. You can pause it. I'm on air by the grace of God. I'm an apostle by the grace of God. I'm a prophet by the grace of God. I'm a preacher and a teacher by the grace. And it's grace. That is not title. It's grace. Many people carry title and nothing in it. Hallelujah. Because the grace of God that you carry, they will bring you results. Hallelujah. That general result is there in the year. God is with the prophet. God called the sister. God called the brother. Hallelujah. Grace.
Oh, yeah.
Yes. So you got to get that title.
No way.
And grace. Grace. The grace they believe, the five ministry gifts are not title, they are grace. In every moment of grace, you are an apostle, show me how many churches you are planted for a packing for money. I'm the person, have you grace? Am I talking to somebody here? Come on, ministry. You are title, that grace you carry to produce results. To move the kingdom of God to the dimension God wants it. The apostle Paul will pray and say, I didn't eat any man bread for nothing. I rub my hands to fulfill them. That's commission. And you on the team. I'm not talking to somebody here. Hallelujah. Vision is expensive. Because one of the things God will tell you is super animal. I'll come to that. Importance of vision, vision determines where you are going by the grace of God. It gives direction to a person or a group of people by God. Go this way. That's why you need leaders that are sensitive to what God is saying. There are 7 words that killed the church. 7 words. We have not gone this way before. 7 words. They have killed ministry. They have killed churches. They have killed nation. We have not gone this. God has the right to teach us our lesson. Hallelujah.
Amen.
What if you are doing ministry your own way? What do you know? It's like this now. They say no, and God will leave you. Mm-hmm. You'll be on your own. So you'll be honest with what God is telling you. Actually, I know God calls you, because you should be everything. You should be small. You start walking, okay? Cancel. That's where you are going. See your picture. They all have to get there. You will send everything you have to fulfill that vision. Your life, your money, your gift, your everything, you push it in because it is divine invention. And in that sense, so to speak, I'm not talking to somebody here. So vision determines, vision will become your mission for life. Your mission is what you do for a living, man of faith, you nothing. Vision. The Bible says, "Kiss the God of all and full repentance." From that on, from constantly speaking, identify the vision that you have. What do you see about your own life? Because every child of God, God has a plan in your life. He said, "I know the plan that I have for you." I call that teacher in teacher. When you discover God's original intention for your life, for what He created you for, and you find a boy, your future is colorful and celebrated. Hallelujah. That's it. Everybody who has got a vision, they have a purpose in life for God. Look at David. Look at Joshua. Look at Pamela. Look at Esther. They follow God's purpose for their lives.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
The power of vision. Vision becomes a vision. You know your purpose. You set goals. You got short-term goals. Okay, but let's not this. I didn't know. We're going to do it by the grace of God. You find scripture. Don't ever take anything to do anything. And you have scriptural proof for it. God allow you. God has that back. And after he shows another, he back his word. Found the word of God. Or what the pillar. Vision from Moses from the palace. In the will of 40 years, God trained him, and God sent him to the literature of Israel. And he stood before the most powerful king on the face of the earth, the most powerful nation. He said, "Let my people go." And Pharaoh said, "Who is your God?" And when God said, "Moses, send the frog, send the mark, send that woman, the last one will shed that ball to let Israel go." God was backing Moses. Every communication is backed by God, is supported by God, is sustained by God. I'm not telling you, you get a vision and you don't even know what you're going to do, you're left and you're right. Vision. Every minister has a unique vision God gave. We know what God wants to do. So we're doing it. We're doing it. God is a God of vision. He gave vision to people. So God gave you a vision for your personal ministry. Do you have any vision for your life? That God said you are a child of God. You know, let me know I'm afraid to ask because if you are not God, you're a preacher. No, I'm not a preacher. But some of God is a preacher. Then I'm not telling God, say, like my friend was discussing yesterday, I told this guy, well, I want to write a book about it. And then we don't have to become personal, and we're just trying to do. It doesn't mean for 4 years. I will write it about it, well, you have to go for me, there's not enough 4 years for this country. Because strategic government is leadership. Our bigger problem is leadership. Leadership is very coming on to anything you want to do. Leadership. Because leaders will take you to where you never think of going before. Because they have a vision. They see far more than you. They know what God said. So they nurture you to follow them into doing the thing you never dream of doing.
Yeah.
So leadership is very important. So I read a book. I read a book and say, if I become president, what I'm going to do. Yeah. And I said, one, or there will be a student grant. We'll have student scholarship, student grant, like in America. All our grandmother high school will become the pillar of our education budget. So each student will send them a student from high school to go to college. When you graduate, you pay the money back. After my bachelor, you go master, you pay, and we get more job. But the more dream power you have, the better you become. Then agriculture, we set our agriculture budget, and we make sure that we have our grant into regions. And every region produces number of food. And so food becomes supper, and we send some food out of this place. I'm not talking to Spencer, and I'm not going to do, I'm not going to be a pen. I'm going to be a pen, it's a premium pen. Only Liberian people can take loan in a pen to do business. I'm not talking to somebody here. Hallelujah. Empower more, raise some more Liberian business people, like in Nigeria. Raise some more Nigeria. They only are going to look at the physical. Build more pastoral, build more schools, train more teachers, and then build more goals, and let electric and send energy all the place so that the Arabs tap the earth. Arabs has electric, the wealthiest of the nations. Without that, and say, you don't have a man. Say to me, why? I said, I'm ready to vote for everybody that will be in that meeting. So I'm provoked. They know where I'm going. If you want to say every 4 years, let me leave my room. I will not let you know how to see when you are eating dog. You have to see Paul bring money to the president. I'm just kidding, don't take that out of context, please. Hallelujah. Please come on, I'm not saying, oh, they don't want it. No. I'm just saying something. God is provoking. And I'm not going to go up. It's provoking for the poor, you know, isn't it? They're not better than you. Not Can't come on in there. Can't you get your problem wrong? And put on cancer and it was simple and talk on me. No. I have three principal kids and you know what I said? I have three questions. The answer that I will go for you. You are happy. Why are you talking about people? Why are you doing that for happy? I will go for you. For our today, I said, I pray for you. For you, I'm eating here, but I die. Hallelujah. Vision. God is a God of vision. God will give you vision about what needs to be done to advance your life. God will give vision to our church to move to the next dimension. Hallelujah. Vision. Because in your vision, it is tied to your destiny. So if you put your vision aside, your destiny is twisted, interested, and you are a track. From Minister, who am I to see you on the church? Because I'm not going to be there. The Bible calls it that. Cannot go for you to do. Know what you're going to do. And brother, I'll be doing it in a job with PNT. You start excited. But if you see all the Lord, tomorrow we'll get from the lead. But you do what God called you to do. Hallelujah. The Bible says, wrong, they say, let them be. And people will run without vision, the people perish. Without money, the vision perish. Without people, the vision perish. Without program, the vision perish. Without plans, the vision perish. Without purpose, the vision perish. Am I talking to somebody? Yeah! Yes. The power of vision. Yes. The demons of vision is that from me. Do you know that? Paul said, what was it? I was arrested to Peter to go. When I let her down, I had no choice. I was apprehended. They said, I'm indebted about this. I'm over. Rewrote the one from verse 14 to 17. Read. He said, I owe God in debt. You know why? Because Paul was a practicing on the human eye. He killed people in the place of God in verse 18 and watched that Paul and said, God, I'm the worst sinner. I'm the least of the apostles of God. He couldn't believe that grace bring into that place of or respect, the place of destiny. You couldn't understand it. The financial of God is the power of God unto salvation. It can change, it can deliver, it can build, it can run. One day I was praying and God showed me somebody and I asked after, hey, you know, many of them we pray and we say, we should the power of God. The power of God, not just in teaching and preaching, it brings development. It brings a lot of stuff. When you say, Holy Ghost, Paul, you carry God inside you. And God will show you what He wants done. And when you start with it, but you continue. How has it brought to me in the name of family? Genesis 26, no matter the relation. In that river, oh, I have so deceived. You will turn around. So tell me, lie, prayer will not change it. Fasting will not change it. You're going to do something, God will take 2 days and this will happen. You'll be able to turn around. Hallelujah. You're going to discover God. You're going to know God for yourself. Let's say, but I say, you will have your own faith. You're going to write on people's faith. Let God like my prophets in a while, so now God will allow you. Because you're growing faith. Faith and being tested. You go to the fire and you go to the faith. Pagan faith told me in the Bible then. Shout out Bishop Benito, your faith told them in the fire of Thomas. They said, when I bow down, they believe in God. They trust God. No matter, even that when I compromise. Think of all the things that are impossible, they are possible with God. If God get that vision wrong, get budget to give you strategy. Platform, practice is how you are. Those that mock you will celebrate you. Those that hate you will not come and say, oh, brother, thank God for you. I bless God for you. Look at you now. You know what? Any government will put in mocking you. They did not see you making. They will be laughing. But let them keep laughing. Let them mock you. Your mockers will be the point of being announcing. They become journalists. I can't think Christ the true minister now. In my meeting, but here could be you. But I see the minister, hallelujah. I'm not talking to somebody here. Yeah. Hallelujah! Every vision may be it shall come to pass at the appointed time and season. God let it be the Lord, He is time and season. So the vision is God in you. You know what? She can declare on God. When the God can love to feel this, He was telling me after our church in the power out there, you know, I saw the church on that. Then the singer church, it was unfinished. Eh, he go. Then he died.